Alright, good day guys, welcome back to another channel. As today we're gonna go into Essendon in this series, part 5 of 18. So yeah, of course everyone had him in the top 4 last year. I know I had him finishing 3rd, so but they ended up finishing bottom 4, so it was a pretty embarrassing season for Bombers fans. Draper won goal of the year, so that was definitely a good sign. It's why I've got this mullet, but besides that there was really nothing much done by the Bombers.
I've got a few people that I know, family and friends, who are Essendon supporters. Don't get upset with me now. Hear me out. It's going to be another long, long season for you guys.
Well,
long season.
We've got new coaching staff. Brad Scott, they've picked up a couple of good draftees. Merritt, now the new skipper of the club, and you McGrath, vice-captain.
Like, their weakness, I see a lot of weaknesses at Essendon, right?
Oh.
That's why they finished bottom 4. The defence...
The defence, they've...
Lacks run and dare from out back. Their key position players are okay, but not enough run and dare. They're going to play some of the midfielders that they play in the midfield in defence. I think McGrath has to go across half back.
You can't do that to McGrath. Well, if anything, you stick him up forward.
Modern football is now you've got to be able to drive and win ball in your defensive half and then carry it and kick it to... a one-on-one contest down forward. Like, they haven't got enough drive. Their midfield, apart from Zach Merritt, is solid, but it's one pace.
Parrish as well.
But now Parrish is a good player, but he's not overly quick. Dylan Schill, his best form is passing. He was a great player at the Giants.
But Devin Smith isn't.
He's retired.
Yes,
like, Dylan Schill at the Giants was a gun, right?
Well,
absolutely, he was a gun. All-Australian, great player. I think injuries...
Definitely.
...have knocked him out a bit, mate. So, and their forward line, they rely too much on Stringer.
Well, they've got they've got Chip and Woody back now, coming back from his personal issues and...
Who else have they got there?
Yelfie.
They've got Sam Wiedemann, but the only time he plays well is against Geelong, let's just be honest there. Like, I haven't seen him play
that with Joe. That was definitely a huge pickup in the off-season for Essendon. And that's all they really did in the off-season. They picked up Will Setterfield, which... was a huge pickup from the Blues.
It's turned up. It's not a huge pickup.
What?
It wasn't a huge pickup.
Well, it's the best pickup. Besides that drafty that I forgot his name, but...
Yeah. Elijah Sardis, wasn't it? They picked up. Yeah, he's injured from half the season as well now.
The Greek freak of footy. So
I think it's going to be a long season for Essendon. If they win more than 7 games, they've done well with this list. I think Brad Scott's going to have his work cut out the first couple of seasons there.
We'll see what happens. Like, Heppel, he has to win a premiership. Like, it's due to come in the next few years to this club. I could definitely see them making the 8 this year. They did beat Gold Coast in that practice match the other day, which is good sign to read.
If they make the 8, who's going to be certainly 8 from last year?
Prince has got Sydney missing out in the 8, potentially Fremantle, Bulldogs.
Fair enough. Because you've already said that Carlton's going to make it from last year.
Carlton, Collingwood.
Collingwood made it last year.
Well,
but so far we've got Carlton, Collingwood, Brisbane making the 8.
I can see how they potentially maybe sneaking in.
So we're going to have 18 teams making the 8, are we?
Well, it's wide open this year. Anyone can win the premiership.
Well, it is wide open. I'll say to you, like...
10 teams.
I think 6 teams realistically.
Well, I can see 10. Like, you never know. Like, did anyone think Melbourne were going to just come up like that and win it? Exactly. So.
But they had a decent list. They did make the prelim in 2018.
Yeah, but then 2 years of being bottom 4, mate.
I know, and then they picked up Luke Jackson and Jose Pickett, and they picked up a couple of players from other clubs. Ben Brown.
Probably Ben Brown.
Well, he might not be a star, but he gave them that structure they needed. But we digress. We move from Essendon to Melbourne. We'll talk about Melbourne a few here besides tonight, but Essendon, 7 wins. I've got them between 7 and 8 wins.
I can see him getting 10, potentially.
I think their forward line... 2 meter Pete, solid citizen, right? He can play a bit.
He's their best player by far. Best and fairest
when he's your best and fairest, your leading goal kicker, you know you've got problems.
Well, Merritt was injured for most of the year. Parrish missed half the year with a knee problem. Stringer, if those guys play, I could see them making the
game. Stringer's already got hamstring problems in the preseason. He hasn't even actually gone out there and done anything on the field.
Yeah, but he's apparently been training really well this off-season. Brad Scott's fixed him up.
Well, there must be something about the cameras that they go to the hangar, because every time I see him on the track, it doesn't look like he's a picture of health. He's always limping, he's walking around, like he's got ice on his hamstrings. I'm not sure what's going on with him.
On a positive note, Tipper kicked the goal the other day. So.
He kicked a goal. It's good to see Tipper back. He's one of my favourites, Tipper. Even though I don't follow Essendon, I think he's one of my... I love the way he plays, the way he competes, the way he can kick goals from any angle.
He could easily get a 40-goal season this year. Maybe 50. Maybe win the Coleman, but... Anyways, they'll do it for episode 5 of this series. Fremantle coming up next. So I'll see you guys next one.